It seems like the Indian lunar mission to the moon has finally ended. Chandrayaan 3 was launched aboard an LVM3 M4 rocket on 14 July 2024, and the lander known as Vikram touched down near the lunar south pole on 23rd August. In this video, let's discuss what it was able to achieve in those days on the surface of the moon, what it basically proved, how the mission ended, and why the end was not a surprise. After 21 days of launch, ISRO performed a lunar orbit insertion on 5th August, successfully placing the Chandrayaan 3 spacecraft into an orbit around the moon. On 17th August, the Vikram lander separated from the propulsion module to begin the last phase of the mission. The lander touched down near the lunar south pole on 23rd August, making India the fourth country to successfully land on the moon and humanity's first to do so near the lunar south pole. On a 40 days journey, the rover had spent over a week collecting data from the lunar surface. But on 2nd September, the lunar night started. Then the Vikram lander and Pragyan rover had been put into sleep mode in order to hibernate and protect the electrical components during the brutal conditions of lunar night, which lasts for 2 weeks and sees temperatures on the moon drop to minus 250 degrees Celsius. On 22nd September, ISRO sent three awakening commands to the lander and the rover, but sadly, it did not respond to the commands. ISRO was trying all methods to turn them on again till 30th September, but they were unsuccessful in doing so, which means the end of the mission. The lander and the rover could not survive the 14 days long lunar night. The rover was actually not planned to awake after 14 days. But ISRO scientists tried to make that work. It was planned to operate only for 14 days during the lunar day. This limited operational period was due to the mission's reliance on solar panels for power generation. Unlike some other space missions that use radioisotope thermoelectric generators or nuclear batteries, which can provide long-lasting power, Chandrayaan 3 had to make the most of the available sunlight. Despite this short time frame, the rover named Pragyan quickly rolled into the lunar surface and commenced its scientific investigations. Over the course of nearly 14 days, it made significant discoveries. One of the mission's notable achievements was recording of a seismic event on the moon. This event could potentially be a moonquake, marking a rare seismic observation on the lunar surface after many, many years. What's causing it? Well, that's a lunar mystery we'll have to unravel in the future. But that's not all. Pragyan brought out the big guns, a laser-powered spectroscopic duo, the X-ray spectrometer and the laser-induced breakdown spectroscope. The mission's main mission was to sniff out water, something that would be gold for any future human missions. But instead of water, it discovered a treasure trove of elements and compounds on the moon's surface. We're talking sulfur, aluminium, iron, calcium, chromium, titanium, manganese, oxygen, and silicon, a rare cosmic mixture. Now, the sulfur part is interesting. You usually find it in places with a volcanic past, like the moon's darker regions known as Maria. But Pragyan found it where it was not expected, in the brighter regions where it landed. It could be a sign of volcanic activity or something different, because this is in the polar region. Maybe related to the thin lunar atmosphere, which is technically called the exosphere. In these polar areas, there is not as much sunlight and it's colder compared to the sunnier equatorial regions. This means that dust tends to freeze on the surface rather than getting blown away like in warmer areas. Scientists think that the sulfur discovery could be a game changer for building stuff on the moon. They're saying that by mixing sulfur into concrete, you can create incredibly strong lunar concrete in just a few hours, and you don't even need water in the mix. This could open up possibilities for constructing structures and bases on the moon way more easily than we thought. This probe was not only measuring the temperature on the surface, but also right underneath the surface. Turns out that by just going a little bit inside the surface, the temperature drops from 50 degrees Celsius to minus 10. That's basically just going below a tiny thin layer on top of the moon. That implies that the lunar regolith and the moon itself seems to be a super strong insulator. That top layer does not conduct heat almost at all. So, there is a very high range of temperature variations between the surface and right underneath the surface. No one would have expected that. Here is actually the graph produced by the Indian Space Agency showing the depth in millimeters versus temperature. By going just a few centimeters into the moon, the temperature drops by quite a lot. Towards the end of the mission, they decided to do a little moon hop. And yes, there is a video of it. Basically, the lander took a tiny leap, going up about 40 centimeters or roughly 2 feet and shifting about 40 centimeters to the side. It was like a lunar bunny hop. Now, you might wonder, why did they do this? Well, it was all about testing the engines and checking if these small hops could be a thing in the future lunar missions. It was like a trial run to see how well the lander can move around on the lunar surface. Cool, right? After nearly 2 weeks of exploration, the lunar night fell, and both the rover and the lander fell silent. With the return of the sun, there was hope for reconnection and further experiments. However, the extreme cold of the lunar night, plunging the temperatures beyond minus 120 degrees Celsius, made survival impossible for the electronics. This marked the end of the mission. Nonetheless, the rover covered around 100 meters during its mission, contributing to India's achievements in the space exploration and one of the greatest scientific achievements of mankind. If you have reached this far, please do not forget to subscribe and share it with your friends and show them that you love it.